Howdy, 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 my beautiful Sagittarius. How are you doing, darling? My name is SimplyVelca, and today I'm going to be getting into your weekly tarot reading, Sagittarius, for the month of July 2022. All right, darling? And if you enjoy this weekly tarot reading, Sagittarius, I have a surprise for you, honey. All right, top right-hand corner of your screen, honey, right here. Click the rubber frog, honey, and you'll find your monthly tarot reading as well for your zodiac sign, all right? If you enjoy my tarot readings, let me know in the comments below how my tarot readings help you out, darling. That's how I keep up with you, Sagittarius, as well as be sure to give this video a like and subscribe if you'd like to know a completely free way to support me, darling. That's how it helps me out a lot, Sagittarius. You know, don't underestimate it, honey. All right, so as well, darling, be sure to consume more when it comes to consuming tarot readings on YouTube today. Be sure to check out more than just your one zodiac sign. Check out your sun, moon, rising, as well as your Venus sign. All right, Sagittarius, but let's get right into your weekly tarot reading today. Let's see what's going to be going down. All right, Sagittarius, your first row, we're going to be tapping into your career and financial situation, darling. All right, and then in your second row today, Sagittarius, we're going to be tapping into your social life. This could be a romantic relationship, platonic, darling, someone in the family, work, darling, your social life. And then in your third row today, Sagittarius, it's going to be covering just your general tarot messages. All right, starting out this weekly tarot reading though, Saggy, we have the Queen of Swords in the back of the deck here. All right. So the quote that I'm hearing is from like Nicki Minaj, I don't know, where it's just like, so you think I'm the bad guy, right? You think I'm the bad guy. It's like, I'll show you who a bad guy is, honey. All right. It's the sense for you, Sagittarius, where it's just like, you had to be the Queen of Swords in a situation. All right. In multiple situations, because I feel as if you had to set the record straight with a lot of things. All right. With a lot of people as well here. All right. It's like your hand was forced into this place of having to set strong boundaries and having to be the bad guy or perceived as the bad guy, Sagittarius. And you're just like, you know what? If you want to make me out to be the bad guy, darling, that's fine. I'll show you what a bad guy really is, though, honey. Let's be first and foremost clear. All right. If you want, like, I feel like for many of you Sagittarius is here, it's like you are finally taking a stand with a situation where you are completely indifferent with how certain relationships are going to be impacted now. Where it's like you're speaking your truth, you're laying down the boundaries, you're laying down the law, and if you like it, that's fine. If you don't, the door is this way, honey. All right, to the left, everything you own in the box to the left, honey. All right, in the closet, that's my stuff. Yes, if I bought it, please don't touch. All right, honey, let's get into this. I don't know why I'm quoting some of these songs right now. That's not like me. Let's get into your tarot reading today, Sagittarius. All right, so in your career and financial aspect, remembering that it is the Queen of Swords that's going to be influencing all the rows here today. All right, you have here the Page of Cups coming in here, Eight of Swords, as well as the Temperance energy coming in for you, Sagittarius. All right, opportunity is going to be finding its way. I feel as if there's this sense of where you're feeling constricted at this time, Sagittarius. Have patience currently. I feel like there's something you have the ability to, like, I keep on hearing, like, you have the ability to transmute this, right? You have the ability to change the outcome of things, all right? You still have time. There's still time left to get to the appropriate funds here, all right? There's still something more that you can develop with this situation, so don't throw in the towel just yet here, all right? Expand your mindset. Expand your horizons a little bit here. You're not as trapped as you're thinking you currently are, all right? You are going to be receiving something. Page of Cups. This could either be from a spiritual aspect, whether this is a spiritual download, whether this is a door opening up for you here, but some new energy is going to be coming into play in your life here, Sagittarius, for your career and financial, and it's going to be really good for you. It's going to be able to help get you out of your head a little bit, and also help, again, like I keep on hearing, like the sense of transmuting energy. Some of you guys, Sagittarius, think about the last time that you've cleansed. All right, some of you guys need to start utilizing crystals a little bit more, transmuting like even like your own negative energy, because we all have negative thoughts sometimes, right? We're all human, right? It's a sense of just like utilizing more with what's in your environment for your betterment, right? Very much so magician energy. That's what I hear with that. All right, being a little bit more selfish or perceived as selfish as well. Sagittarius, it's the sense of where you have to be a little bit more cutthroat. All right, you have to make sure, you know, think about it. And I don't want to say cutthroat, because people immediately think in a very like negative way. I guess that is kind of negative, right? Let me clock my own verbiage or lack of proper verbiage. But think about it in a way where it's just like, let's use the scenario of the airplane, right? Where you're putting the air mask on your face first before you help out your children or help out your neighbor, right? Think about it in that way. Not, I guess, supposedly in a cutthroat way, but make sure you're breathing first, Sagittarius, before others. Let's just move on, Sagittarius. No matter what I say about it, it's just going to sound weird. All right. In your social life this week here, darling Sagittarius, you have the Magician, Knight of Cups coming in here with the Six of Wands. And I'm like, oh, well, there is the Magician. I don't look at the rose until we start tapping into it now. So I like this energy a lot for you here, Sagittarius. I feel like for you, someone that you had to put the boundaries with, all right? It's like you have to lay down some solid boundaries with somebody, or it's like you speak your truth with the situation, Sagittarius, where you're just like, you know what, like, this is how I am right now, take it or leave it. There's going to be somebody that's actually going to receive this in a very positive way for you, Sagittarius. All right, I get like the sense for you, you're going to be receiving an offer from somebody. I feel like you're going to be making a new friend or two. That's what I say with this. It's like this sense, like in the same, like funnily enough or ironically enough, it's like in the same time that you're being like, you're coming off as like the bad guy, honey. All right. The bad guy. I need to stop. My inner barb wants to come out, honey. The Queen of Swords, like the moment you're the one like setting these boundaries and all that, that's at the same exact time that people are noticing you more and wanting to engage with you more, wanting to talk to you more, wanting to see what it is that you're up to, Sagittarius. That's really what I get for a lot of people, especially in like the work environment. I get what it is that you do, like whatever it is that you do gets a lot of attention. Like for example, if I was a Sagittarius, like I would see this, be like, oh, like me doing tarot is getting like people are noticing me doing tarot. There's a lot of people that want to engage with me doing, like, because they see what it is that I do and they want to learn more about it, right? I feel as if you intrigue people, Sagittarius. I know that sounds super weird, but that's like the word that comes to mind. I feel like you intrigue a lot of people currently. Getting into your general tarot messages for this week, Sagittarius, you have the Two as well as the Five of Swords and then the Nine of Wands. All right, 2, 5 swords and then the Knight of Wands coming in here. So overall, Sagittarius, for you guys, what it is, it's like the cards that y'all are being dealt, pun not intended, but I suppose it works, darling. Like the cards that you're being dealt, you can handle it with ease here. Yeah, you're gonna have to change things up here, Sagittarius. I feel like this is there a message that needs to come forward here. It's just like get more comfortable with the idea of detaching yourself from being hopeful about a specific outcome. All right, or detach yourself from the idea of any type of outcome happening and just take it on day by day. I get for some of you Sagittariuses. For others of you guys here, I feel like you guys are going to be dealing with some opposition in the coming days. All right, now I'm thinking about y'all have an op, Sagittarius. I don't know what's going on here, honey, right? Y'all are bringing out, it's something with y'all's energy, Sagittarius, is bringing out bringing out something in me, honey. But it's just like the sense for some of you guys, let's unpack the sense of ops. What is an op? It's someone that's basically opposing you, right? But let's like unpack this into a more digestible, palatable meaning here. I feel as if for many of you Sagittariuses, you're going to be realizing as you are being that Queen of Swords, like the people that just you don't want to be messing with here. All right, I feel like you're going to be losing a lot of people. Losing, I use that very loosely because I feel like you're not losing them because you're not losing anything of value. It's as if you're losing fat, right? And when you're trying to lose weight, right? That's the type of losing that I see this is. It's like you're losing. You get the point. We don't need to really use 50 different analogies, do we, Velca? Let's just get to the point of the messages. But speaking of which, let's start getting into these clarifiers now, darling. All right, we're going to be tapping into your career and financial firstly, remembering that it's the Temperance energy, Eight of Swords with that Page of Cups. Queen of Swords is coming right back out here. So really amplifying this message here. Sagittarius, when it comes to the work life, learning how to have better work-life balance, I feel, for some of you guys here, King of Cups energy with the Justice energy. Yeah, definitely the sense of learning how to have a better work-life balance. Full energy in the back of the deck coming in here as well. Some of you Sagittarius are going to be having somebody coming in to help you get that work-life balance, be able to offer you a little bit more stability here. You might be having, for some of you Sagittarius, you might be having someone coming in to help lighten the burdens from you. All right, you might be having somebody unexpectedly coming in with some offerings of just like helping. If you have been needing to like pay off certain bills or whatever, I feel like there is like an energy coming in to help stabilize things for you here. There is just like this nurturing presence coming in when it comes to your work life here, to bring this sense of balance into a situation, getting things back on track when it comes to your work life again, getting you out of this place of feeling stuck and getting you on the road again. Clarifying your social life, remembering it was the Magician, Six of Wands with that Knight of Cups, Ten of Pentacles, right back out, honey. Devil energy, not surprised. Five of Wands coming in here, back of the deck, Four of Cups. So what I get for you guys here, Sagittarius, is like, while yes, you are very desirable at this time, you're inspiring a lot of people here. I feel like what it is that you're going to be dealing with is like, it kind of speaks in the sense of like family friction. All right. It's like the family, you know, so the words that just immediately came to mind again, it's like, I don't like using the word narcissist. I don't personally subscribe to it because I feel like it's kind of overused, but some of you guys might be, it's like the sense of like the family narcissist or the family mess up, but I feel like most of us would probably identify as the family mess up, huh? Or maybe I'm projecting, honey. Anyway, Sagittarius, it's like this sense of like the family problem maker. That's what I want. That's the words that I want to use. The family problem maker, trying to complicate things. So I just be aware about that. I feel as if when it comes to even family, your answer to when it comes to the situation here is just kind of just like cutting it off at the source, not necessarily cutting people off, but not allowing this devil to really sustain from the oppositions. All right. Cause I feel like that's what it is that they want. Sagittarius, I get like the sense someone's just wanting to pick a fight with you just to be able to talk to you. Like, it's almost the sense of like, yeah, you're screaming at them, you're yelling at them, you're making them feel bad about themselves, but at least you're talking to them. That's kind of a pathetic energy. Someone's really just wanting to get a reaction out of you. Someone's really just trying to distract you, Sagittarius. So it's just like, just don't engage with it, because someone's just looking to be engaged. The more that you just disengage with it and not give it any energy, that devil's not going to be able to sustain itself. All right, getting into your third and final row, darling Sagittarius, you have the Five of Swords, Nine of Wands with that Two of Swords, remembering Tower energy, Wheel of Fortune, Ten of Cups. Back of the deck is the Seven of Pentacles. Back of the deck is the Seven of Pentacles. Some of you guys have been working on a project for a while now. You've been investing a lot of energy into something and it hasn't quite reached its peak yet. All right, think about it like a plant, right? Whatever it is that you've been nurturing, right? It could be a project, it could be a career, like whatever it is, you've been nurturing something, could be even a relationship. The more energy that you continue feeding into this here, it's going to be really positive. All right, y'all are about to be hearing some really solid news here overall. But it's like you're receiving, it's like you're receiving really positive news while also having to, like, while you're in the process of like doing spring cleaning, right? So it's just like you just found out you won like a whole new living room set in the middle of you doing spring cleaning. You're just like, I just finished cleaning my living room. Like, you have so much going on and it feels like you have more stuff being added on, but it's like good stuff, right? While you're dealing with chaos. So it's nothing really bad. So I don't want you to be freaked out by that tower energy, but I get it's just like a lot of changes going on in your life at this point in time, Sagittarius. I won't be surprised if some of you guys are just going to start feeling a little bit of just like just feeling a little bit overwhelmed, Sagittarius. All right, a lot of necessary changes for you guys here. I do want to just really celebrate you guys on being that Queen of Swords energy, because even though you are being perceived as the bad guy, I want to just really reinforce the sense of where you are not the bad guy from placing boundaries here. I feel like for many of you Sagittariuses, you wouldn't be where it is that you're currently at in your life without having to be that Queen of Swords, because no one's making sure that you're eating first before like you had to make sure that you're good, because no one else was checking up on Sagittarius. All right, So let's wrap up your weekly tarot reading here today, Sagittarius. Remember, top right-hand corner of your screen, honey, for that monthly tarot reading. Let's see what Moon Oracle card comes in. Hopefully this tarot reading today, Sagittarius, gave you some resonance, gave you some clarity, honey. You have the last quarter moon in Leo, Sagittarius. Lighten up. Go outside, get some vitamin. What is it? What vitamin is it? Is it vitamin D, honey? Is the sun giving us vitamin D, giving us the D, honey, when we go outside? I think it is. Some of you, Sagittarius, with that Eight of Swords, with that Four of Cups that we pulled for you, kind of makes sense for you. I feel like you guys are a little bit in your head, a little bit. And it's like, while you are in your head, that's the easiest for people to try to get a reaction out of you, Sagittarius. All right. So just be aware about that, because I feel like while you are in this state of really being in deep thought, like you're very thoughtful at this time, I get. And it's like during this thoughtful state, things that normally wouldn't provoke you are provoking you at this point in time. You still want to maintain that same indifference energy that you usually always have, Sagittarius. All right, so just don't, I get like, again, like this sense of just like not reacting to someone or something. So Sagittarius, that's the weekly tarot reading that I have for you, darling. Hopefully you found some cards that did resonate with you today, darling. Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to give this video a like and subscribe. Remember, Sagittarius, if you want to book a private to personal reading with me, my website's linked down below, simplyvelca.com. Next to my social media is TikTok and Instagram. If you'd like to connect with me on a more intimate level, is linked down below, SimplyVelca, same as here. But until next time, Sagittarius, I love you so much, and hopefully I can connect with you sometime in the near future. Bye, darling.